You have been scheduled for a sleep study at University of Iowa Hospitals and Clinics. This will be billed as an outpatient procedure. Please bring comfortable bedclothes and toiletries used for your bedtime and morning routines. Bring any items you feel would help you, such as a favorite pillow. Make sure you bring any prescription or over-the-counter medicines you need to take during the study. Your hair should be clean and dry the night of your study. Do not use oils and gels. Take off acrylic nails and remove polish from your index fingers. Do not nap the day of your study. As you enter the UI Healthcare Complex, drive under the canopy toward Parking Ramp 1. The University of Iowa is a tobacco-free facility. Tobacco cannot be used in any building, vehicle, or outdoor space owned, leased, or controlled by the university. After you walk out of the ramp, turn left. Follow the sidewalk around to the back of the ramp. There are signs that lead you to our entrance. The sleep lab is in the Centers for Disabilities and Development building. If you need special accommodations, please call the sleep lab to talk about them. This is so we can get ready beforehand so you have a comfortable and positive experience. Your security is important to us. Our building is locked at night and the grounds and parking garage are checked by security. Press the intercom button found to the left of the door when you get to the entrance. A technologist will greet you and show you to your room. Each bedroom is designed like a hotel room with a full-size bed, private bathroom, and TV. Your room will have video and audio monitoring to help in your evaluation. Your technologist will be able to talk with you from a different room during the night. You will have time to settle in and get ready for bed. You can relax, read, or watch TV before your technologist gets you ready for your study. If you are a minor, one parent must be with you throughout the study. Children, aside from the patient, will not be allowed to stay overnight. If you are a dependent adult, a guardian or caregiver must be with you throughout the study. A total of 20 electrodes will be put on your scalp, face, chest, and legs. These monitors help us decide your sleep stages. We will watch your eye movements, muscle activity, and heart rhythms. Once in bed, two sensors are put under your nose to check for airflow and snoring. Two belts that stretch are put around your chest and abdomen to record breathing effort. A clip is put on your finger to track your oxygen level. Your index fingers should be free of acrylic nails and polish to make sure we can get a true assessment of your oxygen. This study will be painless. After brief instructions, your technologist will go back to the control room and wish you a good night. They will then start recording. You may sleep in any position and move as needed. If you need to get up in the night, your technologist will gladly help you. You may think it will be hard to sleep with all of the sensors, but most people have no trouble falling asleep. A trained sleep technologist will watch the ongoing recording of your sleep throughout the night and into the early morning. Some studies need you to use continuous positive airway pressure therapy, or CPAP. CPAP therapy is most widely used for the treatment of obstructive sleep apnea by giving a gentle flow of air that holds the airway open while you sleep. Your study will end around 5 or 6 a.m. All sensors will be removed and you will be free to leave. There will be breakfast snacks in our waiting room. Your results will be sent to your referring provider within 2 weeks.